The Kinchaku, classic Japanese design meets modern patchwork. Two sizes and two styles. And this is how you make your own. 13 easy steps from start to finish. Now let's get started. And of course, don't forget to grab your pattern. Choose your squares for the outside of your Kinchaku. And piece your squares into strips. Open your strips and press the seam allowance to the right, left, right, left. And if you flip them over, they should now look like this. Now piece your strips together and turn them into your patchwork panel. Now you get to quilt your panel. You can either do that by hand or by machine. I'm hand-folding mine, and I quickly show you how I do that. And if you need a little more help, please check out my video tutorial on how to quilt by hand. I added a quilter's knot, and now I start quilting. And here both finished panels. Secure your seams by stitching once around your patchwork panel. And then trim it to size. And now we're piecing the lining, which is the AB panel in your pattern. Top stitch the edges of your casing for both of them. Fold them in half and mark the center. And now align the center of your casing with the center of your patchwork panel. And sew your casing in place. Now, add your AB panel or your lining. And sew it all in place. Open your panels, they should now look like this. Place them right sides together and clip it all in place. Leaving an opening at the edge of your AB panel. And again, sew it all in place. Mark the center at the bottom of your patchwork panel and nestle those seams nicely into one another. And now sew on top of that mark for about 1/4 inch. Repeat this on the other side of your tube. The patchwork bottom of your tube should now look like this. Now, pinch the outside seams against the center seam we just created and clip all 3 layers in place. And again, do the same on the other end of your tube. Now sew along the edge on both sides. Now turn your kinchaku through the opening in your lining. And then close the opening by hand or machine. You can find a video tutorial on this right here. Now top stitch along the edge of your kinchaku just like this. And finally, you get to add the rope, making it a proper drawstring bag. And that's it, you're all done. And don't forget your pattern. In there, I walk you through every single step of the process. And finally, did I actually mention that the kinchaku is reversible? Make sure to follow for more.